In the previous lecture, we saw why it is important to improve the load factor and the diversity factor, and we also saw what is the relation between load and diversity factors with the cost. In practical conditions, load factor is always less than unity, and in ideal conditions, load factor is equal to unity. So by improving the load factor, I mean we want to make load factor equal to 1. And when this happens, the cost of electrical energy reduces. So when load factor increases, it approaches to unity, the cost of electrical energy reduces, and this is our prime aim. So we try to improve the load factor. And if we talk about diversity factor, then in practical conditions, diversity factor is always greater than unity. And in ideal conditions also, the diversity factor is greater than unity. So our task is to increase the diversity factor further. And when this happens, when you increase the diversity factor, the cost of electrical energy reduces. Now we will talk about why the cost of electrical energy is reducing by increasing the load factor and diversity factor. If you remember the last lecture, we had two different types of load curves. In load curve A, we had two different types of load demands. The first one is the base load and the second one is the peak load. The base load is always there. It is always there for 24 hours and we have to satisfy it. So to satisfy the base load, we use base load power plants, and the examples are thermal power plant, nuclear power plant, etc. So these power plants, thermal, nuclear, etc., run for 24 hours, and when peak load arrives, during the peak load period, we start the peak load plants. The peak load plants do not take much time to start, and the examples are dams, diesel power plant, etc. So to install the dams to satisfy the peak load, we need to invest high amount initially. You can understand it in simple way. There is cost involved in the construction of peak load plants. There is cost involved in the electrical equipments we are going to install over there. And to cover this cost, we need to increase the cost of electrical energy. We need to charge the consumers more. So when P max is higher, the maximum power demand is higher, which is the peak load condition, then in that scenario, the cost of electrical energy increases, right? And when Pmax is higher, the load factor, which is equal to average power demand over the maximum power demand, reduces. And if we talk about diversity factor, then diversity factor also reduces. And if we think in the reverse manner, if we can increase the load factor, then Pmax will reduce and the cost of electrical energy will also reduce. The same thing goes with the diversity factor. So this is all you need to understand. And if you see the load curve B, you will find there is no peak load. So we only need the base load plants. There is no need to install the peak load plants, and the cost of electrical energy is lower in that case. And it is because the maximum power demand is not there. So we will focus on the maximum power demand. We will try to reduce it. And the plot A, plot B, both are very simple plots which I used to explain you the basic concept. But in actual scenario, you will not find simple plot like them. So I have drawn the plot which is somewhat similar to the plot you will get in actual scenario. Here, this is the maximum power demand Pmax, and the y-axis is the power demand axis in kilowatt, the x-axis is the time axis in hour, and this is the daily load curve. So here we have 24 hours, and our prime aim is to reduce the peak. This is the peak here and this is the peak here. So we will try to reduce the peak and we will try to have a uniform plot. So what are the different ways by following which we can achieve the same? We will study in this lecture. We will discuss different methods to improve the load factor and diversity factor. The first method is to provide subsidies to companies and industries. We can provide subsidies to companies and industries. Now, subsidies for what? Let's take one example to understand this. Let's say there are two industries, Industry A and Industry B. The cost of electrical energy is 7 rupees per unit. 7 rupees per unit, and this is the normal cost of electrical energy for industries. The cost for domestic loads are different, and let's say industry A is operating during the peak load period, that is during daytime. So the cost will be same, it will be 7 rupee per unit, but industry B decided to operate during the offload period, that is during the night. The industry B is operating, so the electrical board decides to subsidize the electrical energy for industry B, and it will provide it at the cost, it will provide it at the cost of 6 rupee per unit. So industry B is paying less as compared to industry A because it is operating during the offload period. So we provide subsidies to the companies and industries which are operating during the offload period. And in that particular way, this peak will spread over the offload period. I will show you quickly. This peak will reduce a little bit because industries are now operating during the offload period. This peak will look something like this. And here, the load will increase like this. This is the new load demand because of industries running during the night time. We can do the same thing with the farmers also. We can provide them subsidies to run their agricultural equipments. They run pump set to irrigate their fields, and they can do this during the night time. The third one is the effective utilization of sunlight. This is very easy to understand. We can use the sunlight and also store it. In that way, the demand will reduce and the load factor and diversity factor will increase. This will make the cost of electrical energy cheaper. Let's talk about the fourth point. We can have different time zones. Now, this particular point is very important. Let's try to understand this by taking one example. In India, we have the same time. India is a vast country and still we have the same time. The Calcutta is having the same time and the Bombay is having the same time. But if we talk about America, then America is having four different time zones. I will quickly paste the picture of different time zones in America. You can see map of USA on your screen, and I have not included Alaska in this map. This map is having four different sections. 1, 2, 3, and 4 different sections. The first section is representing the first time zone, known as Eastern Time Zone. The second one, the yellow one, is representing the Central Time Zone. The third one, the pink one, is representing the Mountain Time Zone. And the last one is representing the Pacific Time Zone. If it is 6 p.m. in the Eastern Time Zone, then the Central Time Zone will be having the 5 p.m. So we can say that the Central Time Zone is lagging by 1 hour. The Central Time Zone is lagging by 1 hour. The Mountain Time Zone is lagging by 2 hours, and the Pacific Time Zone is lagging by 3 hours. So this is how USA is divided into four different time zones. And now let us try to understand how the load factor and the diversity factor will improve by dividing the country into different time zones. There is peak in the load curve during the morning time because the schools, colleges, offices and shops will start to open during the morning time, and the demand of electrical energy will be higher. Let's say the morning peak load duration is from 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. And we also assume that the country is not divided into four different time zones, but the whole country is having the same time zone. So from 9 a.m. to 11 a.m., people will get ready and go to their offices, school, colleges and shops. Now think about the number of people in this vast country demanding the electrical power at the same time. And this will increase the power demand, and we will observe a peak in the load curve. Now, if we divide the country into four different time zones, this part of the country will go to offices, schools, colleges and shops first, and 1 hour later, this part of the country will go to their respective workplace. In the same way, after 2 hours, this part of the country will have the increased demand, and finally, this part of the country will have the increased demand after 3 hours. So everyone is not demanding power at the same time because we have divided the country into different time zones. So under this scenario, we do have the peak, but the peak is not very high. So we can modify the morning peak, and it will look something like this. Now we will also modify the evening peak by using the same concept. This part of the load curve we have improved by providing the subsidies to the industries and farmers. This is also the night time. So this portion is also improved by providing the subsidies. The evening peak will now reduce. And this is the complete load curve after following the methods to improve the load factor and the diversity factor. And if we talk about the maximum power demand Pmax, then you can see the new maximum power demand is this one, and it is smaller than the earlier maximum power demand. So this is the new one, and it is reduced to 1, because of which the load factor and diversity factor will improve and the cost of electrical energy will reduce. You can compare the new curve with the old one and you will find it is much uniform. Now let us talk about the last method, which is having two-part tariff. We can have two-part tariff in which the first part is for the units consumer is consuming and the second part is for the maximum power demand. So we will charge them in two ways. The first one is the charge of units they are consuming, and the second one is the charge of maximum power demand. And there is one more thing I want to explain in this particular lecture, but as we have not discussed the power factor, I will not go in great detail. There is tariff based on the power factor also. We provide subsidies to the industries which are using the high power factor loads. Simply note down this point when we will discuss the power factor and other important aspects. I will explain this particular point over there. So this is all for this lecture. These are the different methods by using which we can improve the load factor and the diversity factor. And before I end this lecture, I will leave you with the daily load curve of Delhi, the capital of India. You can see the date, it is of this Friday. So observe the load curve by pausing the video, and I will see you in the next lecture.